She's a good person, 39 years old, she's been here once or twice, she's a good person. Her judgment is what I question. She marches around with Black Lives Matter to protest what they perceive as injustice in the justice system, which is completely controlled many times by African-American judges. And in doing so, she allied herself with a group who in Dallas, in Minnesota, in Baton Rouge, New York City, and became familiar with police officers. What do we want, Jeff Pence? What do we want to win? Pigs in a blanket, flying out there. New York City, I was there. Thousands of Black Lives Matter supporters and others are marching around New York, calling for the murder of New York City cops. 2 weeks later, a black radical out of Baltimore drove to Baltimore, New York City, and then their police cruisers killed an officer, Ramos and Lou, as they were having lunch, shot him in the head, sitting near a police car. Defended by Dallas cops. During the protest, 5 cops were shot in the head by a high-powered rifle during the Black Lives Matter protest. Same thing happened in Baton Rouge, Louisiana. 3 cops were killed. So, when you're running for the mayorship of the city of Cincinnati, and you align yourself with a hate group like Black Lives Matter, that's a problem. It's a serious problem. People should be judged not by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character and modern behavior. There is a blind spot somewhere out there where you got something. But she doesn't understand that you can't align yourself with a group that's the murder of cops. Did you hear that? And have I missed something? Of course. But somehow, whether it's the Democratic Party, which has enlisted the assistance of Black Lives Matter and others, there's a blind spot. And there's no group in America who cares more about black lives and matter to them than Cincinnati police and Springfield Township police or King County police. They really care about black lives because they protect them all the time. From others who would seek to do them harm. But when it's politically popular and it's politically acceptable, major cities in this country to align yourself with a hate group like Black Lives Matter. And they're not held to the same standards of behavior as other organizations or groups. That's a problem. Now, the Inquirer did a report on those individuals running for city council that didn't pay their state, city, or federal taxes, which is public records. Just by happenstance, the 6 of the 25 that haven't done it were black. So when they ran a story saying these are the 6 people that have not paid their taxes, including Linda Young, that owes the state $25,000, the black community was in turmoil. Because how dare you put the pictures of our leaders and they'd be wrong on the front page of the paper. And then the Empire, because they had no colonies, they had colonies the size of pin shoes, ran a story apologizing for covering the news. We're sorry, not that it would give you objective news coverage in America anymore. We're going to let race determine what we do. So if, I don't even say it, but if you vote for your Yvette Simpson, Note you're voting for a candidate that supports hate groups who call for the murder of cops. Let's continue. Bill Cunningham, News Radio 700, WLW Cincinnati.
Sentences for a locked-up cattle farmer in northern Kentucky, and House Republicans released their tax plan. Tom Demers, Columbus News Radio 700, WLW Weather Center forecast in Milwaukee. News Radio 700, WLW. Ticket information from 333 Seat. 333 Seat is your source for